This is Talk of the Town, a weekly program featuring community events happening in and around Northeast Michigan. With your host, Bradley Summers. And get the latest from Alpena Community College with ACC President Dr. Don McMaster. And now, today's Talk of the Town.
Good morning. Welcome to Talk of the Town. I'm your host, Bradley Summers, and this morning I have two very special guests, two first-time guests on the show. First guest is Jeff Meaden with the PACE program that is coming to Alpena. Hi, Jeff.
Hey, Brad.
How you doing?
Good. Doing very well.
Well, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you.
I've seen a lot in the media sources around the community. A lot of really great people are talking about the work that you're putting a lot of time into and bringing a really important and vital resource to our community, which is PACE. Mm-hmm. What does PACE mean?
So, good question. So, Brad, PACE is the Program of All-Inclusive Care for the Elderly. So, that's a big statement. It's mm-hmm. a big name. But what PACE is it's a program, Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services program, that's specifically targeted for elderly individuals who are eligible for nursing care coverage but want to stay in their home. They're safe enough to live in their own home in their own community. So the mission behind PACE is to provide services for those individuals so they can remain in their homes and remain independent.
Really? And they receive in-home care?
Correct. Yep. So PACE is primary care, PACE is daycare services, PACE is home care services, nursing services within the home that allows patients to have all of those services that they'd be eligible for as if they lived in a nursing home, but they live at home. And then PACE provides those services from a PACE center.
Excellent. So what it differentiates between other services in our community that are doing somewhat, serving some of the elderly population mm-hmm. is that it's the direct correlation that your services would have with the medical field.
Absolutely. So the PACE program, the PACE Center, will have a clinic embedded within it. So it is very much focused on medical care, but that's just one component of the program. So the PACE would be the primary care provider. They would coordinate with specialty care visits. We'll have on-site physical therapy and occupational therapy and rehab services, all of those services available. And when individuals who are part of the PACE program need additional care, whether they need a surgery or imaging services, all of that is covered under the program because the program is actually the insurer for the patient also.
Really? That's awesome.
Yeah.
What a great opportunity though for more aging individuals in Alpena and the surrounding areas to be able to utilize these wonderful services.
Yeah, absolutely. I'd say, one of the things that drew me personally to the PACE program is that idea of autonomy and independence, that we could provide services that otherwise, these individuals, without these services being provided, would force them to make difficult decisions on, do I stay in my home or do I, look at an institution to provide those services? PACE provides the support to allow people to live in their homes.
Yeah, and alternative home situations for aging individuals is expensive.
Very much so. PACE is a program, similar to a nursing home where insurance kind of covers the services. Majority of individuals in PACE programs across the country and across the state are what we call dual eligible. They typically have Medicare and Medicaid, and if that's the case, then there is little to no out-of-pocket costs for the individuals who participate with the PACE program.
And where do individuals that would provide these in-home services, where does your team come from?
Yeah, so we're gonna hire a team. We are in the early stages of developing the program. We're working on the building and construction. Hopefully within the next 3 to 6 months, we're gonna be hiring a team of at least 30 individuals. But PACE is really built around a design of what they call an interdisciplinary team. So that's the physician, the home care nurse, the occupational therapist, the day center manager, all of these, the transportation director, all of these individuals are kind of focused around the needs of the participants, and they make decisions daily based on the needs of the participants. And we change kind of our scope. This day it might be home care and keep the patient at home. The next day it might be coordinating the bus to pick up the individual and bring them to the day center. The next day it might be a combination of both mm-hmm. with a clinic appointment. So really that's kind of how the PACE model works.
And you kind of touched upon it too in the segue going going into it is, you know, I know in January there were some articles in the Alpena News that was put out there about locations.
Yep.
So it is kind of a hybrid between a house, between in-home care and the ability to go to a physical location as well.
Yeah. So our PACE center will be within the city of Alpena. We are working to secure that location now. What we're looking at is somewhere between 17,000 square feet and 22,000 square feet of space.
Wow.
So a big center. Average clinics are 4,000 to 6,000 square feet. So this is so much more. And a lot more of it is those day centers. Services, so you know, a full kitchen, everything that the participants need to make them feel at home when they're at the day center.
Now, doing some just basic research on the PACE programs themselves is that there are 14 different programs throughout the state.
Yep. So the state of Michigan, so thinking bigger even nationally, I think there's 159 current programs and over 200 PACE sites. The state of Michigan actually was one of the earliest states in the country to develop a PACE program. That was PACE Southeast Michigan in 1994. They have grown to 8 different sites. I was on site last week and it's amazing. And in the state, yeah, there's 14 programs. There's never been one here in Northeast Michigan. So PACE programs are unique where they serve a very specific geographic area, and there's never been one here. So we are working to develop that one that will serve Presque Isle, Alpena, Montmorency, Alcona County, and then some postal codes kind of, you know, moving outside of those counties.
It's awesome. And, you know, we were talking just before the show, too, that, you know, the model of the 14 programs or the 100 and was it 29 or 49?
159
yep. programs. No one is exactly the same.
No. Each PACE center is unique. So we're building it right, we're doing it right from the start, and we're learning from partners within the state. So PACE is being built here in this community with a partnership between Presbyterian Villages of Michigan, who is a partner to create PACE Southeast Michigan and PACE Central Michigan. So they have years and years and years, decades worth of experience with two successful programs, and then with NEMSCA. So NEMSCA has served this community for years, so it's a great partnership that we have those local connections and the connections with experience with PACE.
Well, and don't be too modest too, your connections too with the medical field and your past experience working with, you know, in that field as well is definitely going to equate to quite a bit of success in our area.
I would hope so. You know, this community, there's exceptional healthcare facilities. PACE is going to complement those, and that's our goal.
Awesome. Well, Jeff, thank you so much for being on the show today and explaining to everybody what the PACE program is and giving some clarity, and, you know, really excited to see what great things are going to happen and things that you're going to accomplish under your leadership here. But I wish you much luck, and I really look forward to the next time that you come on about building updates and updates about the program itself.
I can't wait to come with those updates, Brad. It's exciting.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Stay tuned after the break for Michelle Bailey from the Sunrise Mission. Welcome back, everyone. Our next guest is Michelle Bailey from the Sunrise Mission. Hi, Michelle.
Hello. Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for being here.
It's my pleasure.
You've had a lot of, you've been with your position now for quite a while. What? 2 months, right?
Just over 2 months.
2 months?
Yes.
And you've had, prior to you being the executive director of the Sunrise Mission, you have some experience in the field.
I do. I was in ministry, street ministry, and some other ministries, and had a lot of opportunity to be on the street working with homeless.
Excellent.
Yes, well, it was incredible.
And the reason I bring that up is that we were at an event not too long ago, and it was just wonderful to hear your experience and the passion that you have and the great ideas that you're bringing to the Sunrise Mission. I think that is extraordinary, and it's so refreshing to see, you know, people in the community with passion.
It is an exciting time. It is, especially when we can serve those who need it so desperately. Mm-hmm. And there are so many native Northern Michigan families and individuals that are in need of shelter, and for various circumstances, and reasons, from everything from losing a job to trying to be sober, which is very important in our mm-hmm. shelter, to a number of different facets. You know, they find themselves in a situation that they cannot provide for themselves. And so it is wonderful to be in a position where we are helping people help themselves.
Now, a little bit about the program itself. Tell us a little bit about what Sunrise Mission does, maybe where the funding comes from, and the sources of support from our community.
We are 100% donor funded. And so 100% of our funding comes from generally our community that sees the need and recognizes what we are doing there and trying to help those that need help. It's interesting the success stories that we do have, and it is so well worth it. So, for instance, some of the individuals that I have had the privilege of meeting over the last few months that are completely on their feet, independent, they own homes, sometimes businesses, they have families. And what's interesting is many of them are volunteering and very active in their churches.
Yeah.
So it's incredible. And it makes every guest worthwhile.
Well, and it goes to those basic, like Maslow's hierarchy of the, you know, getting to that self-actualization, that pinnacle of that pyramid, you have to have the basics and the needs and the essentials like shelter and food and love and care and everything else. And I know a lot of what you're doing is providing those exact things for individuals that need it in our community.
It is incredible when we have families that come in and children that are cold, and we're able to provide them clothing and shelter, and even immediately clothing that we're putting on them and feeding them and giving them a place. And it's very rewarding when we see adult individuals going in the right direction for their lives, where they are actively employed and they are building a future for themselves. And it's exciting to see them realize some of their potential and their passions.
And you were saying, too, with individuals that are coming in with children, is that frequent?
It is frequent. In fact, we generally have children that reside with us as guests. And we are very thankful for a number of agencies as well as other nonprofits in the area, such as the Boys and Girls Club, because a lot of our children, there's a need that fulfills. And so I am enjoying partnering with a number of other area nonprofits to work together and make the most of what we have to offer for one another as well.
That's what, and I find that really incredible too, is that, you know, I knew of the Sunrise Mission and a lot of people in the community do, but, you know, just in the last like 2 to 3 months since you've started your leadership there, I've heard a lot more in the community and about the services and the more exposure and, you know, in the nonprofit realm, which all the guests on the show, you know, are in, is it is so vital that you stay relevant and that you have a voice and a seat at that table and have the community continually understand the services that are being provided.
Absolutely.
With pure transparency.
Absolutely. And there's a lot of misconceptions. And so one of the things that's interesting is that we only primarily serve guests that reside, and many of them are native to Northern Michigan. And so they are actually in our community and are in need of this assistance. And our goal is to see them fulfill their destiny and the purpose that God has given them, and to be active, positive community members. And that's exactly what we're seeing.
And when you're serving people, it's not just here in Alpena.
It is not.
You're all over, right?
Well, no, we are based in Alpena, but our guests come from an 8-county parameter that is in Northern Michigan, and that's the area that we serve, with many of them native to the area itself. So it's pretty incredible.
Yeah, not too far off from, you know, the first guest when we were talking with Jeff about, you know, the model of the program is fit for the communities that it serves. And,
absolutely,
you know, it sounds a lot like that's exactly what you're doing as well.
Absolutely. We do have some needs. Our building and our facility is somewhat tired and in need of everything from roof repairs to cabinetry to flooring, you name it, furniture, which needs to be specific to the building, but also volunteers, people that are willing to actually invest time in developing relationship and encouraging our guests when they are walking through difficult transitions towards their goals. Mm-hmm. It's not an easy transition, and it's amazing and well worth it, but I'm looking for opportunities of even community experts to teach in variety of classes and workshops to help better prepare them for life living independently.
Well, you can ask me. I would love to come in and teach a class on helping, you know, with child care needs and some of the services that, you know, my
wouldn't
organization.
Wouldn't that be wonderful? Yeah. I would love that.
See, and that's where that passion is right there.
It is.
I feel like, I just feel it when we talk, is that there's so many things that you're wanting to do and willing to do to bring in those services to help the people that need it most. And that's my mission with my organization. So it's just incredible. And I'm so thankful for you being here.
Well, and I'm thankful for you too. One of the things too that we are offering is any nonprofit or agency that is in the area of Alpena to please utilize, scheduled of course, our conference room and our kitchen, and we have a couple lavatories at no charge. So we want to help support those that are also out there in the field in various degrees, doing what they do and fighting the good fight alongside us.
Awesome. Well, Michelle, thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.
I really enjoyed listening and learning about what the Sunrise Mission does, and I'm really excited to see where you're going to take it with your wonderful team there.
Thank you.
And look forward to many more updates in the future.
Thank you. Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you so much. Stay tuned after the break for the ACC segment.
Greetings, everyone, and welcome to Talk of the Town. I'm Dr. Don McMaster, president of Alpena Community College. I'd like to share this morning with you a couple videos that have been produced at ACC about ACC activity. The first is a testimonial from a graduate of our four-year electrical systems technology degree, and his name is Musa Kaba. Many of you folks know Musa. He's a wonderful guy. And he graduated from the four-year program and is having a great career out east. That program mainly focuses on getting power onto and off of the grid, substation control, grid design, grid maintenance, these sorts of things. Very pertinent. And Musa's doing great. So enjoy what he has to say. It's very valuable advice. And the second video has to do with our a utility tech line workers program. It's absolutely robust, filled to capacity. And this is a video about their competition at the National Collegiate Linemen's Rodeo last spring, where they did phenomenally well, as they almost always do. And it's a lighthearted, fun look at a group of guys that went out and competed nationally and did very, very well. We will be hosting that National Collegiate Lineman's Rodeo at ACC next spring, a year from now, and we're looking forward to it. So enjoy the videos.
Once you get in the job market, they don't care about which college you go to. Like, I was joking with a friend. I was like, hey, you know, remember, I got my bachelor's degree from ACC. And I make the same amount of money as people that have, like, you know, 120K in student loan. I don't have any student loan. And we all do the same job, you know, and I don't have to do any training, you know. I have a lot more experience, you know, what I'm doing than they do, because they didn't get enough lab time than what I did here at ACC. So not only that you have enough time in the classroom, you have a lot of time in the lab, so you get more out of your little money that you spend compared to, like, you know, a lot of these big colleges. And when it comes to the job market, people don't ask me, like, what college you go to. They just ask me, like, you know, what you can bring on the table, like, you know, what you know. They ask me about my background. They don't ask me about my college. You know, they don't really care about that. So if anyone is having any doubt coming to ACC, you know, don't have any doubt. You can make it out there once you get your degree, I'm sure.
My name is Sharissa, and I'm originally from a very small town. I never thought my life would go in the direction it is when it came to this course. It came upon me by happenstance and was thrilled to go through it. I learned a lot, and when it came time to graduate and to transition to the work field, it made the transition super easy. it gave me an amazing opportunity to further my future. I've had a lot of rough things in my past, and coming into this program changed a lot of things. I went from one addiction to a very healthy another addiction. It's an amazing opportunity, and to move forward into something that's different is amazing. And I have Walt, Hank, and Dawn, and you, Dr. Don, for all that, and I greatly appreciate every minute of it.
Hi, I'm Ray Peterman, and I'm a utility arborist. Going through this course, like, when they see you're having a hard day, it's personal. They pull you off to the side, they talk to you, they make sure you understand what's going on. It's all hands-on, and they're great. They actually care. And now I go clear power lines. I go out in storms. I keep the lines running so you can leave the lights on for your family so they can come home. Thank you. Going through this class, I started out with Asplen, and I know more than a guy that's been there for 8 months. So he's been training hands-on with Asplen, and I'm already ahead of him.
Not only that, when we went through this course, it was more than just a class. It turned us into a family.
That's right. That's right.
Seen another wrong and right. No, everything's not black and white. There's always something in between. No matter how long or well you live, you don't get anything you don't give. Still, no slate is clean. For better or worse, anybody can take a look around and find a better man. Upright, no matter how he's faring, no matter what kind of shoes he's wearing, the shoes he's wearing, they don't make the man. So many people out running around, handicapped before they hit the ground, thinking there's nowhere to go. Shouldn't we all be looking for ways to keep on seeing our better days? We're not chained to what we know. But if your eyes are open and your mind is free, there's no telling what a man can be. Upright, no matter how you're faring, no matter what kind of shoes you're wearing, the shoes you're wearing, they don't make the man. Find your feet still walking the line. You'll never carry the load worth bearing. No matter what kind of shoes you're wearing, the shoes you're wearing, they don't make the man. Won't make the man.
I hope you enjoyed the videos from Alpena Community College. Thank you for watching, and we will see you again next week.
This has been Talk of the Town with your hosts Bradley Summers and Dr. Don McMaster. For a list of community events taking place in Northeast Michigan, please visit our website at WBKB11.com and click on our community link. This has been a Queen Bee's Knees LLC production, a Morgan Murphy Media Company. All rights reserved.